I just had to exit the highway here because there is a place down here called Salt Creek, and I will go down and explore that area. And we have to go down a little dirt road here. It's not too bad, actually. It's very well maintained. Usually these dirt roads can be really rough, but this one is kind of easy to drive. It's probably a mile. So this is the parking lot at Salt Creek. And I will just show you, do one sweep. And I noticed, and I remember, they have these nasty mosquitoes here. They will bite you. So you have to be moving. You can't be standing still because they will come and attack you. There is one other car here. And they had a couple of kids. And they were enjoying a little hike here. This high temperature. This is the beginning of the trail, and they put up a little sign, the Salt Creek trail here, with these. And oh my god, I'm under attack here. I don't know what it is, it's these horrible flies. And I hear this. Oh god, he bite me. Oh my god, what is that? I have to run. Crazy, they are like bees. My goodness. I'll be right back, I need to kill that thing. I actually managed to hit that fly or mosquito slash bee or whatever that was. So I survived, but it bit me at least three times. All right, so what do we have here? Look at this formation here. It's carved out again by water, and you see the ground is white, salty. And again, during the rainy season, this is probably full of water, and it looks like cement, like that same color as concrete, totally gray. Very interesting. And the area in between here is just carved out, it's flat, and here is another fly. Oh my god. You kind of need bring jogging shoes so you can run away from them. All right, so I'm coming here. This walkway is turning. I'm guessing the lower we get, the more water you will have. And you probably have a small population of this pupfish surviving there during the dry season, and then when it rains they get more water and they can explode in the population, right? And they have these benches here, but the problem is you sit down here, this evil fly will come and bite you, right? So I will just pass. It's a big area. It is, really. I mean, when you park, you can't really see it. And if I'm looking back up, okay, we came from up there. So it's a little valley in between these muddy sides here. And I can see water. Not much, but maybe enough so the fish can survive. Maybe you can see that down here, right? It's like yellowish water. It's not even, it's barely 6 inches deep. Wow, and I'm walking here. It's a muddy side in contrast with the beautiful sky today. Deep blue sky. Okay, I had some camera problem here. I'm back. And as soon as you stop, you're under attack. And I hear them, they are just flying by. But you see, there is water here on this side. And also a little bit here on this side. And it's about, the deepest point is probably like a foot, not more than that. And it might be more down there, but you can't, they don't allow you to go down there, which I can totally understand. You see the water here under this little bridge, and these stupid bee flies. I don't know what it is. My God, horrible. Oh, two under attack. I'm just under attack here. I have to run. This is action in Salt Creek. They attack you, these evil flies. Maybe you see them. You can't stop. And they land on your t-shirt and they bite you right through. Oh my God, here's another one. I have to run. I'm under big attack here. Not only one, many of them. Holy cow. Do you see them? Okay, your nasty flies. All right, that's good. At least, I hope you can see something of the beautiful landscape here. But you will be attacked. Oh my God. I tried to find some shade down there, but they are actually hiding in there too, so you can't really escape. Ah, that was fun. Okay, I'm just pushing forward. You have to walk here. I did not expect so many of these flies, right? So you can't really stand still and enjoy the place. Maybe this is, you know, the reason this is an empty place. No people here. Because if you go here, I have long pants, right? To protect my legs in the sun. Can you imagine if you come in shorts? My goodness, you would be totally attacked. And we do a last sweep down here. Because right now there are no evil flies flying around me. They actually show some animals here, some birds, some dragonflies, stuff like that, that lives here close to the salt. I would say this area is almost halfway in between Furnace Creek and the sand dunes. So you start at Furnace Creek and you go north, kind of halfway up. You make a left into this dirt road and you drive a mile and you park. And about 3 seconds after you leave the car, you are under attack. So bring your ping pong racket when you go here and you can smack them one by one. Hey, they talk about the pupfish in California. Probably, you know, remnants from these big lakes. After all, this was a big lake many years ago. hundreds of thousands of years ago, this was a lake. And we are just at the bottom of it. All right, so the question is, can I recommend this place? And yes, I recommend it. But be prepared, I have one behind me. You will be under attack. So long sleeves, long pants, definitely a hat, because, and you need to run. My God, he's here. And they're fast. He's just doing this area in like a few seconds. And then as soon as you look away, woof, they are back, they land on you. But besides from these evil flies, yeah, it's a beautiful area. Totally super beautiful. Here's one. Oh, I hit him. Nice. That was a 10. I took him out. All right. So, enjoy the bees. Bye.